In this illustration, we'll discuss about a satellite falling into a planet due to atmosphere. Here we are given that a satellite revolves around a planet of radius r in an orbit of radius nr. And due to change in weather, it is given that atmospheric density increases and satellite experiences a resistance force which depends on the velocity of satellite as alpha v square, where alpha is a constant and v is the speed of satellite. We are going to find the time when satellite will hit the surface of planet. Here in this situation we can see when a satellite is revolving around a planet, like say if this is the planet of radius r, and say a satellite is right now at the orbit of radius x and moving at a speed v, then its resistance force is acting in opposite direction, due to which its speed increases. Due to the gravitational force on it, its radius also decreases by some value, so it comes in. We can say its radius gradually decreases by dx, dx, dx and so on, and follows a spiral path and gradually coming close to the surface of the planet. Now, in this situation, we can use one. Satellite is at a radius x and speed v, and its speed is v, then in a short time tt, if its radius decreases by dx, by work energy theorem we use, say if its initial kinetic energy is ki, then if its radius decreases by dx, the work will be done by gravitational force, which can be written as plus g m m by x square multiplied by dx. And x is decreasing here, dx can be taken negative. Plus the work done by friction force, which is also negative, so I can write minus friction force on it is alpha v square multiplied by the distance traversed by the satellite in the direction of friction, which can be taken as v dt is equals to the final kinetic energy of satellite after time dt. So this time is t and this time is t plus dt. So in this situation, the difference of kinetic energies can be calculated like this. If kinetic energy we consider as half mv square, and dk, the change in kinetic energy, we can write as mv dv. And the value of speed in an orbit of radius x, we know it is root of gm by x. So, if we substitute the value here, the value of dk will be m multiplied by root of gm by x multiplied by dv. Here, dv can be given as minus 1 by 2x root of gm by x dx. So, in this situation, the value of dk we are getting is minus gm m by 2x square dx. So, if we substitute the value of dk by taking this initial kinetic energy on the other side, this becomes minus g m m by x square dx. And in this situation, this minus alpha v cube dt is equals to the value of dk here is change in kinetic energy, which can be written as minus g m m by 2x square dx. Further rearranging the terms of dx and dt on the opposite sides of equality, here we are getting minus g m m by 2x square dx is equals to alpha v cube. V we can take as gm by x. So this gm by x to power 3 by 2 dt. Further, this one x gets cancelled out over here. And finally, we are having the result as minus m by 2 dx by root x is equals to this alpha root gm and dt. And here we can integrate these terms at t equals to 0. The value of x was nr, and after time t, say it reaches to r, the surface of a planet. Then on integrating, we can see the values we are getting is, I'll substitute the limits also and incorporate this negative sign in reversing the limits. This will be m by 2 multiplied by this twice of root r multiplied by root n minus 1 is equals to root gm alpha t. And further simplifying this, we are getting the value of time after which the satellite will reach the surface of planet is m by alpha root small gr. Here I can take small g is equals to gm by r square, which is the acceleration due to gravity, multiplied by root n minus 1. That will be the result of this problem. So you can simplify this and verify the result, and the whole analysis is quite important in various cases of analysis of satellite motion experiencing a resistance.